CVA's Acura Series, Bagara barrels for guaranteed accuracy, nitride for guaranteed rust proofing, and a rifle guaranteed to be the best muzzleloader you've ever shot. CVA, it's just a better gun.
All right, everybody, this next segment's being sponsored by Courtney's Restaurant and Catering. Y'all can find them at 4066B North Mount Juliet Road, or give owner Tom Courtney a call for all your delivery or catering needs at 615-754-7548. Stop in and see them, and be sure to tell us hello if you see us while you're there, and tell Courtney so much we appreciate what they do for us right here at the show.
Pork chops, macaroni and cheese.
Oh, man. Tomorrow's catfish day. Today was roast beef day, and tomorrow's catfish day. So get on down there and get some of that catfish, because they ain't hardly any better, man. I'm telling you what.
Loaded
mashed potatoes. Yeah, you're killing me now. I wish you'd had him come down here tonight.
I told you, I don't know why he wasn't here.
We'll have to get him back next week for you. Oh, man. Well, Dayton, tell me a little bit about what's going on in your world right now. What's biting? Where you been fishing?
Man,
what you been doing?
Man, the walleye are starting to do their stuff, you know. We've had a little bit more rain this year than normal, so we've had some more water moving, you know. Last few years, it's been kind of dry, so they wouldn't start generating, you know, till 3 or 4 in the evening. Then they'd cut them off at 8 at night, so there's really not enough water moving. But if you look, man, all of our dams are moving. They've been moving water, so it's going to bring the bait up a little sooner, make stuff happen.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty much everything, your crappie, your rockfish, your bass.
Yeah.
I mean, sauger, walleye, they're starting to do it. I mean, it's cooling down. The water's finally cooling down a little bit. Shad and bait's coming up. Everything's starting to happen. Really.
Starting to get back to being outdoorsman.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there's not as many jet skis. I don't like jet skis or nothing. I'm just saying.
They have slowed up a bit.
Yeah, they've knocked it
they
down.
They slowed
back
their roll. I noticed that at Nickajack the other day. I said, you know, we ain't going to see many jet skis in the day. It was chilly. Mm-hmm. But I tell you what, about 10:30 that
they
morning,
come out.
Boy, they fooled me. There's two of them come past. It's about 60 degrees outside. They come by some new things. They had to have been froze to death. But, no, it's much less pleasure boat traffic and stuff like
zero
that.
Traffic.
And just a lot more enjoyable time to get out.
Mm-hmm.
If you're like us, I mean, we're typically weekend. You know, we're not professional fishermen.
That's right.
You know, but it's hard to get out there on the weekend.
I don't know what y'all talking about.
You got to go at night. Yeah, that's right. I forgot. And we do got one question.
But it was so hot, you couldn't even go out there and enjoy yourself. I mean, it was just literally smoking hot.
No.
I mean,
we spent all summer night fishing.
Yeah, I mean,
I got into night fishing, and once I went that first time and realized I sat there 6-7 hours and didn't ever break a sweat, that's it for me.
Yeah,
I didn't go back during the day again.
That's right.
You know, it was over with for that daytime fishing, but it's getting back.
Yeah,
you know, our temperatures are back where we want them to be now,
right.
You know, getting in the 70s.
Yeah.
And, you know, like I said earlier, that the crappie are starting to come
up
some.
Crappie, catfish.
I've been getting some good crappie reports, and we had another good night with sauger not too long ago.
Mm-hmm.
I went out there the night Cordell Hole, like you say, they were moving some water, and at times, you know, it seemed like it was actually pulling harder than others, and no joke, when that would happen, when you start seeing them lines drift, boom, boom, boom.
They
love
that current.
I mean, it's like it just turned them on like a switch.
That's what you wait on.
But you know, it's at sauger and walleye, you mentioned them, they're only going to get better. It's time.
Yeah.
Right now, it's just going to keep better and better. And,
I mean, but really, like in all these tributaries, all the stripe, white bass, and just pretty much anything that's in the river is really
active.
It's
eating. It's feeding time.
Yeah.
You know,
they're fattening up for the winter.
Now, tell me about this moon, guys. Now, I have known and studied a lot about the effects of these big full moons like we have right now. We got a biggie coming up at the end of October, and there's a lot of argument around it both directions, but in my opinion, it does affect deer movement. There is some change on deer movement. Do you think it affects the fish like it does deer?
I think it does. To me, you know, aside from the science that people say behind it, I feel like it causes them to feed more at night, and then it seems like I've noticed the midday bite better when you got that.
So it's a lot like a deer.
Yeah.
You know, you'll see more midday movement, and they seem to turn on. I would agree with that. They seem to turn on more on that full moon. When Dayton and I were down at Dale Hollow this year, it was on a full moon, and they're just active.
What happens is, you know, you get your shad spawns on full moons, and that does a lot for the lake. And then you have crawdads that hatch on a full moon.
Crawdads do a lot
So there's a big, you know, a full moon plays a part of everything. I mean, it's not just The animals, it's fish. Yeah. It affects people. Yeah. I mean, it does. It's literally...
Like Randall Haley says, if it can have a pull on the tide, it can have a pull on the deer.
That's right.
That's the way he puts it. But, I mean, it's the truth. And, you know, there's a lot of studies, just to be honest, that say, well, there's no effect on deer movement from moon pool. But I certainly can vouch, as far as myself, that I see a lot more midday and early afternoon deer movement on a full moon.
Right.
Now, they're still going to move morning and afternoon like they always do, but they seem to get up and feed when they normally would not.
I can remember as a kid, my daddy said, you know, used to tell me, you better stay in that stand till 11, 12 o'clock on the bright moons, you know.
So on the way to a tournament, you'll see deer moving in four or five different places.
Yeah. That's right.
So, you know, stuff's active.
While it's still dark.
If you see, you know, if I'm on the way deer hunting and I see a bunch of rabbits running around and stuff like that, the deer gonna move.
Absolutely.
I'm telling you, wildlife, it's all like they're all joined together. If them rabbits are out running around, deer.
I think cattle or something that can tell you a lot. You go by, you'll
see
them.
They can, cattle
move.
Laying down in the field.
Yeah, they're laying down. Well,
guys, I promised y'all a giveaway tonight, and it's time to do that. So if you'll be the fifth caller, 615-737-7767, we have got a set of earrings for you from our friends over at Lure Couture. So be the fifth caller again at 615-737-7767, and we'll be right back here in just a minute with some more Southern Woods and Waters.